night I held a little hand. It made my sad heart sing. It was the loveliest hand I've ever held. Four aces and a king.
Just
I hadn't finished. 30 days hath September, April, June and November. All the rest have 31. It's so unfair.
Just two of the many...
Roses are red and violets are blue. So goes the age-old rhyme. But I know roses are blue and violets are red. I've seen them hanging on a line.
Just three of the... Oh, of the collected poems of East End poet John Bossom under the title Life is Like a Double Bed. Why did you call it that?
Well, I've always believed that it's true of life. It's probably the most profound statement I ever made in my life, you know. But all the things that like, are gone in a posterior and all that, you know, and all the phrases and all that, you know, I think it's the most meaningful thing I've ever said. Life is like a double bed.
Why?
Why what?
Why is life like a double bed?
Well, if you're going to bleed and argue about it, life ain't like a double bed, you know? You know, don't get your knickers in a twist, love. I'm only talking, you know, you know.
Mr. Bossom, you've got this reputation for not conforming, for being a bit of a rebel. Do you feel this is due to your upbringing, your background?
Yeah, definitely, yeah. Because, like, my whole family, we don't conform, you know. I mean, why should you? We won't be dictated to, you know. We go our own way, do our own thing, you see? I mean, that's what it's about, man, isn't it, you know? And that, like, my mum, she's a rebel. My mum cooks with Kerrygold. And you know, some mornings, like when we like having coffee, we just have it, you know, just have a coffee, just like that, you know, when we don't shake the jar and listen to the grand music. Not unless if we feel like it, we do, you know, and we get that nice Jamaican lady from next door to come and, you know, jiggle about like it. But if we don't feel like it, you know. I mean, the thing is, you see, if you don't conform like nowadays, you know, people think there's something wrong with you, don't they? I mean, like, I got a long hair, ain't I, you know? Well, you got long hair as well. I mean, you ain't a fella, are you? Anyway, I mean, they see me walking down the road with long hair, they think, aye, aye, you know, they think straight away that I'm a smoked addict. You know, I want to pot and all the time, don't they? You know, then they find out me name's Bossom. Well, that's a stupid name to give a kid, isn't it? Bossom. That's neither one thing nor the other. And then when they find out... Then when they find out I'm a poet, I mean, they think, aye, aye, you know, long hair and a poet, aye, aye, get livid, you know, I could hit him with my handbag sometimes.
With all this ready-made entertainment available at the touch of a button, do you think there still exists within people the urge to write?
Well, all I can say to that, darling, is walls. You look at a whitewashed wall anywhere in London, it ain't whitewashed for long, is it? I mean, the grubby little pencils are out, scribbling on there. Kilroy was here. Happy New Year to all our readers. I mean, there's probably as much feeling gone into Fred Fancy's flow in the whole of Charles Dickens' Romeo and Juliet. I mean, I tell you, I've seen some lovely walls. I tell you, there's a wash and brush up in Chatham. I've never read poetry like it. Beautiful it is, the meter, it scans, it's poetic, you know. One or two spelling mistakes. And some of them illustrated. Lovely. Shows vivid imagination in that, you know. It's a beautiful sight. It really is. You should go and have a look. Oh, you can't. But it really is beautiful there.
Why do you suppose that they find inspiration in a place like that?
Well, the solitude. The magic of the moment. This feeling of being cut off. I mean, how can you define the tangerine?
Mr. Bossom, may we now have a poem from your new book?
Right, yeah, this book is called Now is the Winter of My Discotheque. And this poem sums up for me in its entirety all the superfluity of modern living and everyday affairs and all that. The soldier sat in the army jail and his mother had brought him a pudding. But the sergeant said it was against the rules, even though it was a good one. Then he saw the look in the mother's eyes and he knew she was feeling hurt. So he did a thing he thought he'd never do. He helped a soldier to desert. The soldier got hold of his pudding. And he ran with it back to his cell. Then, put out your pudding for drink. He heard the sergeant yell. If you want treacle on your pudding, put it out without delay. The soldier put out his pudding. And the sergeant took it away.